I was just curious about the structure. It was kind of unusual to see a 7-episode TV series. And I wonder, was that a deliberate decision at the very beginning when you were structuring it going along the way, or did that come in post-production?
No, the show was conceived as 6 episodes, and that's what Netflix approved. And we had 6 scripts, and that's how it was shot. It was in post-production. We had quite a long assembly of all the material that we shot, and it was timing long, which I was kind of conscious of when we were shooting. And so we ended up with about 10 hours of cut footage, and you know, it was all pretty good, so it wasn't like easy to just throw stuff away. And it was a real challenge, I would say, to get it to a final cut. I mean, Scott and I, as I said, have a 30-year relationship, so you know, we deeply respect each other. And but I've had this experience, especially with writer directors, you know, Minghella also made things that were quite expansive and long, and it just tends to be harder for them to let go and kind of be ruthless with their own work. So this was a real editorial process. We screened it when you know the episodes were much longer, for kind of friends and family, you know, trusted opinions. Then we also, of course, had to show it to Netflix. And they were a great partner, I gotta say, very supportive, you know, had smart things to say, but they never got into trying to micromanage us creatively at all. But their big thing was about the first episode, which, you know, this is new to me. I've never worked for Netflix or any streamer, and I had never made a limited series before. But everything they said was about, let's call it retention, you know, that the whole key is that you want to make sure that people finish number one and immediately press the button to go to number two, you know, that, and they have all the algorithms, and they know, you know, when people start watching, how many stay on the ride, and when do they tune out? So they didn't really care how long each episode was, except they felt very strongly that the first episode should be under an hour. They really didn't want us to kind of wear out our welcome, or you know, almost like you have a full meal and then you have dessert and you can't eat anymore. And the first episode we had was an hour and a half, I would say. So we had some, you know, big challenges. And at some point, I would say sooner than Scott, I realized there was just no way we could get this down to 6, that it would really mean taking out major story elements. You know, it just wasn't nipping and tucking and taking the air out and, you know, compressing stuff. It was just like, you're going to have to lose, you know, Harry or some whole, you know, character run. And of course, he didn't want to do that, and I didn't want to do that. So I started to talk about 7, you know, but he had written it as 6, so it had like beginnings and endings. And it was a domino effect, you know, once you change one, it affects all of them. But as often is the case, you know, I said, let's just try it. You know, you have the other version, you know, it's not carved in stone, but let's look at it and just as a experiment for us. We didn't want to show it to Netflix. And the whole key to the show working editorially, in my mind at least, was when we had the idea to end the first episode when she falls off the chair and the pills smash on the floor. That wasn't at all how it was written. There was a lot more story in that episode. And in fact, what you see now is, you know, she kind of blacks out. And then the next scene is her standing in the doorway of that room at some later moment, and Jolene comes over and they have a sweet, you know, scene between just the two of them, you know, she, and you kind of already understand that she's, you know, been in trouble and, you know, been kind of banished from playing chess and other things. But in the script there, and in the book, there's a big scene with the director of the orphanage where, you know, she's called on the carpet in front of everybody and read the riot act and, you know, banished from playing chess. And it seemed, of course, when we were writing it, like this is one of the pivotal scenes of the story. You know, we couldn't imagine the story without it. But when we restructured it, we found that you needed very little of it, actually, that you kind of understood it. And so you right now you only see like a few short shots in the second episode, almost like as in a flashback of that actual scene, which was, you know, probably a 4 or 5 minute scene. And then once we kind of got over that hump, everything else started to, you know, not fall in place, but it opened the door for us to see where to go with the rest of it.
And I do, and I do.